Hello everyone, Xenosim here. Welcome back to Let's Play Hyrule Warriors Definitive Edition. Last time, well for me it's been quite a while since last time. I believe, I don't remember which one we did. I know we effectively progressed the story, but on to the next chapter. But before we go on to that, let's talk about Toon Link again, because they were given two fighting styles, and now we're using the Sword of Light. Their fighting style is weird in the fact that you're pretty much only going to be using this combo, because it's the only pretty damaging one. Because otherwise, you're pretty much not going to be doing damage, as I'm going to show, with this. Like, what are you meant to do with this? It's nice that the Pokemon Sword is actually the ultimate one, though. So it's a bit strange that two abilities are just the spin attack. Trust me, but we'll talk about the guy I keep picking as our partner. So because how quick that was. Yeah, and this is the map. To get into the center, you need to defeat two bosses, which one I believe is over here. No, I need to press wrong. Yeah, I think that's the one. And the other is over here. I believe it's this one. No, it's this one then. Yeah. Then you can get into here, which starts here. And yes, I'm going to be doing two characters this episode because we're running low on characters we can actually play in the... And I want to make sure that some of the final maps don't have... Well... Repeats? Have bios? Ugh, words. So we're going to be using Young Link, aka one of the game breakers. Young Link is a bit unwieldy at first, but that's partly because their gimmick is connected to their spirit. By pressing X while they're using, while they're not in the middle of a combo, they can use the ocarina to actually fail the game, and I keep accidentally doing that attack, maybe one of the other attacks. Yeah, that combo's pretty good. one it is. Well, here's the special. Show what it looks like. Yeah, that's the combo I'm looking for. It looks weird with the Fierce Lady, but it's actually really good. Now, special guest from Skull Kid, as we slice up the moon. Put the bunny hood on him though. map is actually one of the easiest to unlock everything for, and it's because of this train car. I'm not joking. Just to show the item shop. These train cars are really useful, except for the steel one. These are also pretty good. But you want mainly the spirit train and the golden train, because they affect the whole map. And, oh, it's so good. You can't buy them, but you can duplicate them with the stones. Plus, gotta admit, I love this remix of the spirit track train theme. Legend mode. Okay, we did Lake Hylia last time. Now we're on to Temple of the Sacred Sword. I think I said this last time, but if you're playing this new file, you have to use Link. I'm just trying to think. I mean, I could use the horse. But Zelda's also behind. And I think that would also be good to just... Because this is going to be the map that this is able to shine the most on, being honest. So, yeah, we're going to use Zelda.
Souls closed in each era, Link and his allies were reunited. Sheik was at last revealed as Zelda, relieving much worry about her fate. Meanwhile, Ganondorf had recovered three of his four spirit fragments. He chose to leave Sia's body, her usefulness at an end. Free of Ganondorf's control, but tragically corrupted, Sia resolved to make Link and the Triforce hers and hers alone. Using powerful rituals to strengthen her forces, she redoubled her attacks on Hyrule. But all was not lost. Zelda directed her forces to the Temple of the Sacred Sword in search of the one thing that could save them all.
Indeed. Yes. The I believe in him trope. God, man. This song. It should not go as hard as it does, but oh man, it does. That's one loop, and I don't think you need to do it. You're clearly anymore. Oh, you gotta admit, it should not go as hard as it does, but you're always the land that it is. Yep. game. I know. Come on. I know. We will get there. I will. Recognize him here, though, so he can send in some troops. Pressing B she's playing Yakuza 0. You'll notice someone spawned. Yeah, there is dialogue, but it's like it's more of a forward player being like, "Hey, look over here." Thank you. material. Vanish. Some of them quicker than others. Yeah, if you believe going, if you are using a pot, it's fine. If you're using Zerunia, it's Ruko. We're going to try and take all the keeps first. No more spawning monsters. The door time. You knew you were. You were. I swear that must have been a slight mistranslation or something, because that makes no sense. Like, you weren't hiding, you fought us, you knew we weren't hiding. And going, you fool, makes no sense. Haven't you changed? have to do an escort mission because they added this into this. I don't get why. This wasn't in the original. Well, it was. It wasn't mandatory though. The worst part is, this part can actually glitch. I have actually had it where it was Zelda, because I wasn't playing as Zelda, just get locked in place and I had to push her. So if you are doing this, potentially do this with friends so you don't have to worry. We'll leave some enemies behind so... being stalled by dark forces. Get in there. Stop being distracted by the enemies. Get in there. Good. Now run. Trying to go up a little, but boom, 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 boom. No more good road. That's the last we'll fight. That is the last we'll have to fight Grizzrow as the heroes. Of the story, at least. But will it be as easy as that? I wonder. Next time, we'll be doing a war spirit, then her true self after that, and then Darkness Falls. And then after that, it's Shining Beacon. And then we'll get into the next segments, and oh boy, I'm going to enjoy that! But I'll be seeing you guys then. This is Yonzuma, signing out.